morning, Nighthawks.
I'm Rebecca.
And I'm Kaylin.
And Alana's on the teleprompter.
And Isabel's on the mixer. The date today is October 10th, 2023. The weather will be a high of 77 and a low of 47, partially cloudy and a little bit of sun.
Math Count starts the Monday we return from fall break. If you're interested in joining, sign up on My School Bucks ASAP. Space is limited. If you have any questions, please see Ms. Mertz in room 110.
The American Association of University Women and an Arapahoe Community College invite you to Girl Power. This free event enables CCSD girls and one of their parents to come and learn more about how to get set up for college success by starting on a good path in high school.
While the girls are busy learning about career pathways in psychology, technology, health, and business, parents will have the opportunity to hear from presenters including DCSD School Counseling, Concurrent Enrollment, Arapahoe Community College, CSU Pueblo, and College Planning Solutions. The event will run from 9 a.m. to noon on Saturday, November 11th at the Arapahoe Community College Sturm Collaboration Campus in Castle Rock.
Space is limited to 100 girls plus one parent per girl. Registration will open Monday, October 23rd. RSVP is required. Stop by counseling office for flyer.
Hey, Kaylin, guess what time it is?
What?
It's time for the pledge. Please stand, put your hand over your heart, and say the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey, Nighthawks, enjoy making crafts and creating memorable pieces? Ms. Robledo will be hosting a craft club, second quarter, open to any 6th, 7th, and 8th graders. You will help create a multiple different projects to keep and cherish forever, but most importantly, have fun. Make sure to sign up on My School Bucks as soon as possible. As spots fill up quickly, Ms. Robledo is looking forward to having you.
Speaking of clubs, esports is starting up soon. For those who didn't know, they are looking for students who want to have fun playing video games. Talk to Ms. Winlow if you have questions, and make sure you hurry to register because spots are limited.
Hey, Kaylin, what does a ghost eat for dinner?
I don't know, what?
Spaghetti! Ah!
Go.
Okay, First Priority Club will be starting their morning meetings for this fall semester. First Priority is a student-led, faith-based club where students have the opportunity to gather and discuss important topics, encourage each other in their faith, and have fun together.
If you are interested, join us this Thursday morning at 6:45 a.m. in Ms. Hamlin's room, room 245. This club will continue to meet every Thursday morning as well.
If it's your birthday,
then this one's for you.
Happy, happy birthday from Nog News to you. We wish you happy birthday so we can eat cake too. Woo! That's all we have for you today, Nighthawks. Have a talented, thoughtful, thriving, thrifty, tumbling Tuesday. Bye. Roll it.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. Born and raised on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cooling, all shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it." First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air living like? This might be alright. But wait, I hear the prissy bourgeois and all that. Is this the type of place that they just send this cool cat? I don't think so. I see when I get there. I hope they're prepared for the Prince of Bel-Air. The plane landed and when I came out, there was a dude looked like a cop standing there with my name out. I ain't trying to get arrested yet, I just got here. I sprang with the quickness like lightning disappeared. I whistled for a cab and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, man, forget it, yo, home's the Bel-Air.
I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.